Joe Louis Arena. Dressed in red and white, the colors and emblem echo a glorious past. The 91-92 Detroit Red Wings filled these rafters with screams of victory. Now it was time for the Stanley Cup playoffs, and Red Wing fans could feel the fire burning.
I hope they take it on four straight. That's my wish.
No fear. Detroit is going to take it.
In the opening round, the first place Wings would face off against the fourth place Minnesota North Stars. Last year, the surprising Stars rode hot goaltending and a punishing defense all the way to the finals. This year, they were looking to do the same. But the Wings had their own intimidator, speed. In game one, with Minnesota on a power play, Sean Burr broke up a pass and Sergei Fedorov was off to the races.
Here comes Fedorov, in there, score! Fedorov, shorthanded, it's 1-0.
Detroit took the early lead, but not for long. Just minutes later, the Stars tied it. And in the second period, they scored again to go up 2-1. Then, with just 2 minutes to play in the period, Fedorov struck again.
With a shot, Casey catches that and gives it away, scores!
With the crowd still on its feet and time running out in the period, Steve Yzerman put the Red Wings back on top.
Shepherd.
But Minnesota would not go down easily, and for just the third time all season, Detroit could not hold a lead in the third period. The Stars scored two unanswered goals and stole game one. Then, the unthinkable happened. Minnesota won game two. The Stars' 4-2 victory in the second game put them up 2-0, with the series now moving to Minnesota. For the Red Wings, Minnesota's Met Center was a house of horrors. They had won here just once in the past 2 years. And to make matters worse, all-star goaltender Tim Cheveldae was struggling. The Red Wings quickly found themselves down 2-0 just 10 minutes into game three. It was here that the Russian rocket Fedorov took center stage.
Center to center, here's Fedorov breaking away. 2-1, the Red Wings are on the board.
Fedorov's second shorthanded goal of the series was just the spark the Red Wings needed. Only 3 minutes later, rookie Nicholas Lidstrom tied the game.
Piece of changes on the power play, shot from the point, they score! A screenshot from the point by Nicholas Lidstrom has tied the game.
But the Stars continued to battle, and Cheveldae continued to struggle. Two quick second period Minnesota goals sent the Met Center crowd into a frenzy, and Tim Cheveldae to the bench. Vincent Riendo, in only his third appearance as a Red Wing, entered the game in relief. It was gut check time for Detroit. Riendo made the stops when he was tested early on, and the Wings responded to their wake-up call.
The centering pass, Carson shot it. Andy Van Helleman's pointing to the net, saying that puck went in and the Red Wings will get the goal.
Carson's goal brought them within one. Then with time running out in the game, Ray Sheppard swatted the puck out of midair to score his biggest goal of the year.
The shot, loose in front, chipped out, they score! Knocked out of the air by Ray Sheppard, and the Red Wings have tied the game.
The Wings had fought back from their second two-goal deficit of the night, and in doing so had grabbed the game's momentum. It took just over 1 minute of overtime play for Detroit to end the game.
Bounces to the corner. Mike Craig is there for the North Star. Up the boards. Racine scores! Yves Racine shot from the point, and the Red Wings are very much alive.
Yves Racine's rocket blast lifted the club to its first playoff victory. But the celebration was short-lived, as the Stars would come back to take Game 4. They now owned a commanding 3-1 series lead, and many wondered if the North Stars' playoff magic would work miracles again this year. The Red Wings entered Game 5 with their backs to the wall. They were only one loss away from another first-round elimination, and the pressure to take this one was enormous. Back in goal was Tim Cheveldae, and the 24-year-old stopper knew it was do or die.
There's a lot of hype, a lot of hoopla starting the playoffs, and I may put a little too much pressure on myself. I don't know if that's the right word, or maybe put too much into it, and I felt that maybe I changed my game and changed my style, and then finally about 3-4 games into it, I said I'm gonna play the way that I played for 80 games, and you know, if they beat me, they're gonna beat me playing my style.
The hopes and dreams of an entire team rested squarely on his shoulders, and on this night, Chevy was flawless. Now it was up to the offense to get on track. Midway through the first period, Steve Yzerman took a pass from Fedorov and showed his all-star form.
Now Fedorov jumps it to Yzerman. Yzerman shot, he scores!
Cheveldae and the Wings made the one-goal lead stand up into the third period. The atmosphere inside Joe Louis Arena was thick with tension. Then, with less than 7 minutes left in the game, two rookies lit the fuse, and the Red Wings fans exploded.
Alec overskated it, marked the point, made sure, looks it ahead, Sellinger shot, score!
Big goal! What a shot by Sellinger!
Martin Lapointe's perfect pass and Mike Sillinger's first ever playoff goal allowed the Wings to breathe a collective sigh of relief. Jimmy Carson's empty net goal finished the scoring, and the Red Wings' hopes were still alive. In Game 6, Tim Cheveldae was once again called upon to come up big. And once again, he would respond.
He's in behind, Racine, shot, save, Cheveldae! Gagne catches up to it, he's in, backhand, save, Cheveldae! Carefully locked at the shot, save, Cheveldae!
On this night, the astonishing goaltender was simply perfect. Ironically, Stars goalie John Casey was matching Cheveldae save for save. For 60 minutes, neither team could score. The game moved into overtime. The action played like a Hollywood suspense movie, with each team walking the thin line between victory and defeat. Minnesota desperately wanted to end the series here at home. For the Red Wings, a win tonight meant a tie series and a new life. Then, 16 minutes into the extra period, Fedorov apparently snapped in the game winner. But the Wings' celebration would be put on hold. The shot had moved so quickly that officials questioned if it had indeed gone in at all.
Right now, let's have a look at it. Does it go in or not?
There's no question about it. The puck's in the net.
If we have,
they're going to see it upstairs. Rob Schick is going to the penalty box now.
It is in, ladies and gentlemen.
No question about it. This game is over.
Finally, the game was declared over, and the Red Wings, the victors.
And Yzerman's going
away. It's a goal.
Game seven is on.
Incredibly, Detroit had fought back to tie the series at 3-apiece, and now headed back home for the final showdown. A standing ovation welcomed the Wings back to Joe Louis Arena. Only a week earlier, there were few who believed that there would be a Game 7 in this series. But a reborn Tim Cheveldae and the city's newest sports legend, Sergei Fedorov, had led this team from darkness to daylight. So now it came as no surprise when Chevy shut down Minnesota once again and extended his splendid streak of shutout minutes to over 3 hours. There was little doubt as to who would ignite the Red Wings' offensive attack. As they set out to complete their historic comeback, all eyes turned to number 91.
Miller gets there. Oh, yes, Fedorov in front. Score! Sergei Fedorov was all alone, and he has given the Red Wings a 1-0 lead.
Once Fedorov opened the door, the Red Wing offense came charging through.
Center, tip save, rebound shot. Another tip to score!
The Wings led 3-0, but they weren't finished yet. They answered a second period Minnesota goal with 2 third period scores to put the game and the series away.
Inside shot, all the way through, they score! John Burr may have deflected it indeed. And if there was any doubt, there is none now.
The final score read 5-2 Detroit. The remarkable character and poise of this team had carried them from the brink of defeat to become only the 9th team in NHL history to come back from a 3-1 series deficit. For a team that was left for dead, it was a triumph of the spirit. Inside the Red Wing locker room, winning smiles were everywhere.
We never really questioned that we couldn't win the series. We didn't know if we were going to be fortunate to get back in, but we never had a doubt that we never really lost the confidence that we could win the series, and just kind of kept playing and got ourselves to the 7th game, and we liked our chances in the 7th game at home.
I just kept telling myself, focus. I says, I knew the crowd was going to be excited to start the game, and I says, you know, told myself, don't worry about the crowd, just go out there and be really focused. And that was probably the word that's been used most of my vocabulary to talk to myself is focus.